यस सर।
Provide main. I told you just now, you ask for the two numbers from the user, and then I require two for loops I and J. I will be looking after the numbers that is from 11 to 20, and J is, I will tell you when I'll write J, and I require one variable status, as I have used the same thing in prime. For next thing is clear screen, that you all know why I'm asking for the clear screen, and then after clear screen, printf, enter two integers, and then ask for the integers, %d, %d, and a comma b. Now I'll have to find out all prime between a and b. So for that, I know what is my starting number. My starting number is a, my ending number is going to be b, and between a and b I have to find out all primes. Now that means your first number is a, I, because I is a, so first number is a, and then you have to check whether a is a prime or not, that is I is a prime or not. So to check that, I'll have to start the new loop. Okay, j is equal to 2, j is less or is equal to I by 2, I is 11, so 11 by 2, 5, okay, and j plus plus. So it will check whether from 2 to 5 any number divides your 11, any j divides your 11. Okay, so I'll have to check whether my I, which is 11, I plus, whether j divides, whether the remainder is becoming 0. So just check whether any j, whether j is equal to 2 or j is equal to 3 or 4 or 5, up to 5, if any j divides I, which is 11 at present, then your I is not a prime. Agar kisi ne divide kar diya, to ek baat aur yahan pe aayegi, status. Status will be 0. And I'll say every I, each I is my prime number. 11 is prime, 12 is prime, 13 is prime. All of them are prime. So whenever I'll take a new number, my assumption is going to be not here. I won't write here this. What is this? Kya ho gaya? So here I will write status is equal to, I am writing status over here, status as 1. I am saying each I, whatever I will be checking for prime. Initially my assumption for that is prime only. But if that I is divisible by j, then whatever I said is wrong, then my status will change to 0. And break. So if there are two statements, I wrote curly bracket and J I will close. Let me check what is my status. If status equal to 1, then that I have to print. So printf %d put a space comma I. And then I'll close my this outer I, first I, get ch. And then I'll go ahead with this one. Again, I'll explain you the whole program. I'll say all prime dot C. Run. You take 11 and 20. You can see prime numbers are 11, 13, 17, and 19. Let us work out this program. First number is 11. Look at this place, first place. Ye line mein dekhna aap. I kya kya karega? I is starting from 11. I will go up to 20. Is that clear? Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
Uske baad mein aapne likha hai status. आपने स्टेटस लिखा वन, उसका मतलब क्या हो रहा है कि आपका इलेवन, आपने अज्यूम किया इलेवन ट्वेल्व, एवरी आई इज अ प्राइम. अब वो आई एक एक नंबर देगा किसको, जे को, देख भाई ये प्राइम है क्या, जस्ट चेक दिस प्राइम, दिस नंबर इज प्राइम और नॉट, दिस नंबर इज प्राइम और नॉट. सो आई विल कीप ऑन गिविंग द न्यू न्यू नंबर्स, फर्स्ट इलेवन, देन ट्वेल्व, देन थर्टीन, देन फोर्टीन, एंड जॉब ऑफ जे लूप इज टू चेक वेदर दैट नंबर गिवन बाई आई इज अ प्राइम और नॉट. So whenever I'm taking a number, I'm taking with an assumption, let every number which I'm taking from i's, that is from the first loop, is a prime number. And then from 2 till half of that number, so first time I'm getting 11, 11 by 2 is 5. So then I'm checking down that whether 11 is divisible by 2 or 3 or 4 or 5. So I could see that none of the j is dividing my I. So then my status will remain 1, status will not change. सो वेन एवर माई स्टेटस इज वन दैट आई आई विल प्रिंट. तो मेरा 11 के लिए 1 ही रह गया, चेंज नहीं हुआ, इसलिए वो आई को मैंने प्रिंट किया. नेक्स्ट टाइम आई कितना देगा, आई विल बिकम 12 एंड 12 इज लेस देन 20, सो फॉर 12 स्टेटस इज 1. एंड जे विल स्टार्ट अगेन फ्रॉम 2, 2 टू 12 बाई 2, 12 बाई 2 इज ऑलमोस्ट 6, राइट, 12 बाई 2 इज 6. एंड देन वॉट यू कैन सी दैट 12 इज डिविजिबल बाई 2, सो स्टेटस विल बी 0 एंड स्टेटस विल बी 0, सो दैट आई विल नॉट बी प्रिंटेड. Is that clear, students? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Next time, I will be 13. I will be 13. And again, for 13, status will become 1. Again, hume status ko bar bar loop ke andar reset karna padega. Kyun reset karna pad raha hai? Why I'm writing status is equal to 1 inside the loop? Because 12 mein aapne dekha, it has become 0. For 13, when I'm testing for 13, again, I have to assume the same thing, that let it be a prime. So again for 13, I'm checking from 2 to half of 13. Half of 13 is 6. So whether 13 is divisible by 2, is it divisible by 2? 3, 4, 5, 6. Koi divide nahi karta usko, right? So then status will remain 1 only. It won't become 0. So if the status is 1, that I is to be printed. After printing that I will be taking 14. And 14 status will remain 1. And for 2 to 17, 2 to 7. Which number is dividing 14? 2 is dividing, right? So status, yes, will sir. Become, status will become 0, right? So if the status is 0, then that I will not be printed. That means 14 will not be printed. Next, I is 15. I is 15, status is becoming 1, and 2 to 7. Which number is dividing 15? 3 is dividing, right? 3 is dividing, 5 is dividing. So it's enough. If 3 is dividing, I will break the loop. I will not check up to 5. So then I found out status has become 0 for 15 and it is not 1. So then 15 will not be printed here. When that number will be printed, when I will be printed, if the status remains 1, that means no J is dividing your I. Hello? Hello? I hope. Is there anyone having any difficulty in this?
No, sir.
Please ask this program. I have recorded this program now. Please do ask if anybody is having any difficulty. What is the role of first loop? It's just because you need to find out all prime between what? Between any two numbers. It can be 30, 40 also. You can check up this. I will run the program for 30, 40. So I just generating the number from 30 to 40 and J is checking each number between 30 and 40 that which number is a prime. So you found out 30 and 40 mein there are two primes, 31 and 37. These two are primes, right? And
yes, sir.
Who checking? Yes. So what was the role of I? I was like an assignment and J is like a question. So I is, you know, first assignment. First assignment may so many questions like, you know, I is like, you know, outer loop is just giving one number every time and J is just checking them whether each number, what I is passing to J, whether it is prime or not. So role of J is to check them and role of I is to give each number, okay, generate so many numbers. You can check between any two numbers, maybe you can check between 40 and 50. You can see that there are three primes, right? Students?
Yes, sir. Yes.
You can check 20, 50, 10, 10, 250. You can see all prime between the two numbers. So this is what my program I want to write, though, which how many primes are there. If I want to count how many are there, how will you count them? If I wanted to count the number of primes, if I wanted to count how many primes are there between two numbers, And I also find out the sum between the two primes. Then all you do this. I wanted to count how many primes were there. So let me count. I'll say C++. And I wanted to add all these primes together. Sum of primes between two numbers. So see this. If somebody will tell you the changes, how will you do that? Because I know the status is one, that number is a prime. So my count, initial count is zero. C is zero. Right now the number of primes are zero. And right now the sum is also zero. So both total are zero. The number, if status is one, count will increase by one. C plus plus. Now it's first prime, second prime, third prime. And each I is a prime which I'm adding with sum. And then before you close this, you can say here, what number of primes is equal to percent d, how many you got c primes, and printf sum of primes between percent d and percent d is percent d, comma. So sum of prime between a and b is sum. Let's check now this output. I'm running this now between 10 and 20. So just have look at the answer now. So number of primes 4, sum of primes between 10 and 20 is 60. If you want, you can check and verify. Is it 60?
Yes, sir.
Check. Yes. 10 is common between, that is 40. 1 plus 3 plus 7 plus 9. 9 plus 7 is 16. 16 plus 4 is 20. So total is 60. Mr. Vignesh, you are the discipline in charge, okay? Mr. Vignesh. Hello. Mr. Vignesh, kidhar gaya?
Okay.
I saw only one student who is helping the teacher. Rest of nobody wanted to say anything, right? I'm not at all happy with this class. I'm happy with only one student who is along with the teacher. Mr. Vignesh. I know after my meeting they are going to talk to you.